रेडी स्टार्ट. व्हाट आर द लार्जर इम्प्लिकेशंस ऑफ अरविंद केजरीवाल्स अरेस्ट फॉर इंडियाज डेमोक्रेसी एंड व्हाई हैज इंडियाज रूलिंग रिजाइम एम्बार्क्ड ऑन सच एन एक्सट्रीम मूव. टू थिंग्स आर पॉलिटिकली नोटवर्दी अबाउट केजरीवाल्स इनकार्केरेशन. First, Kejriwal is not the only elected chief minister to be imprisoned. Hemant Soren, Jharkhand's chief minister, was also recently jailed. The more important point is that other than Congress, Kejriwal leads the only opposition party which rules in more than one state. The AAP has won subnational elections in Delhi twice and has won power in Punjab. It has also developed a noticeable presence in Gujarat, which is the original home base of the BJP regime. Secondly, Kejriwal's prosecution unambiguously follows a standard recent script. This newspaper has reported several times, including recently, that opposition politicians have been targeted in over 90% of the corruption-related prosecutions. Indeed, the weaponization of corruption-probing agencies becomes even clearer when we note that corruption charges are normally relegated against those politicians who leave the opposition and join the ruling party. For several years, the leading democracy rating institutions of the world have been downgrading India's democracy. But India was not the only country that was identified as going through what has come to be called democratic backsliding. This is important, for it contradicts the notion that the rating agencies were anti-India, which was one of the arguments BJP supporters often made. Viktor Orban's Hungary, Erdogan's Turkey, and even Donald Trump's America were classified as democratic backsliders. By and large, two questions have marked the international assessment of a country's democratic performance. Is the country in question an electoral democracy? Is it also a liberal democracy? The concept of electoral democracy is episodic, covering only the elections. In comparison, the idea of liberal democracy covers not only what happens during elections, but also the conduct of a polity in the 4 or 5 years falling between two elections. If the electoral side of democracy asks whether elections are free and fair, the concept of liberal democracy adds some continuous features. Are citizens free to speak, or are they afraid to express themselves? Stop.